the Blockchain Innovation Conference on June the 7th in Utrecht at Rabobank. Be there.
Hi, I'm Vincent, Everts Trend Watcher. This week is completely packed with blockchain news, so I'm going in it in a rather fast rate. In 2 weeks, the Blockchain Innovation Conference in Utrecht is taking place. We're so busy, it's amazing. Let me tell you the highlights of it. First, I was talking to Startup Delta and to Prince Constantijn van Oranje, and we had a very nice talk about what we're going to talk about the conference and the importance of startups, of changing big companies. And he's well aware of blockchain, he's really good at it, and I think he has something interesting to say. So that's a really interesting interview. By now, I hope that you know that the theme of the conference is to go from proof of concept to production. That's also what we talked with Prince Constantijn a lot about. Proof of concept are, on the other hand, still important. And Rutger van Zuidam, who made a fantastic hackathon with 60 teams and lots of different places, he's going to come and talk about the role of innovation, of like a hackathon in the corporate innovation. And he's bringing a couple of teams. My favorite team is the team of the machine ecosystems, who are talking about drones and how drones can be on the blockchain and autonomous driving drones and doing all kinds of useful things. So that's Kryha. That's really wild stuff, artificial intelligence, big data, drones combined on the blockchain. And on the other hand, we also have the Unchained team. And Unchained is a track and trace of medicine. You know, about 60% of the medicine sold on the internet, they are false. And you know, the blockchain would be a fantastic thing. And Unchained itself also is presenting at our conference because they have a platform to connect the blockchain to everything around it. So to have all the oracles connected to it. Every, you know, the internet of things need to be connected in a systematic way, connecting to other ICTs. So that company is presenting too at our stuff. Also, it's interesting that this week, the first commercial blockchain trade finance transaction was done by a consortium of banks. And they're also ABN Amro and ING are together presenting that thing. It's called Easy Trade Connect. So that's really interesting how we can do financing trade finance with on the blockchain, very fast, without much fraud, potentially much lower cost, and transforming commodity trades finance, and a whole bunch of banks are involved in that, including RING and the Rabobank, or the ING and the ABN AMRO. So, and you can see on the ING, it has a nice video which explains everything. Then, from India, we have somebody who's part of the team which helps to put blockchain in India at all kinds of different aspects, you know, on identity, on finance. And imagine that your prime minister is so enthusiastic about the blockchain that he really is in front of it. He's holding a whole speech about it. And he's telling the importance of blockchain in agriculture, but in all kinds of different things, to get rid of fraud, but also to open up transparency. And he's having a very intelligent talk about it. So you're going to get that next. We're going to have a lot of different governments talk about the blockchain and how the government is using it, but also how they want to make blockchain a tool to organize all kinds of different parts of society. It's really going to be very interesting. So Diederik Zimmerman is something I'm really excited on because he's in the electric charging. He works for an upstream of RWE, and they've come up with a new energy company. And I worked with this project Smart to do the Oslo to Rome tour, and it's that with the blockchain app I can charge everywhere in Europe. And that's also very important that we can charge everywhere. And we basically, I participated in that. I went to Germany and everywhere in every country I could charge. And it was a transaction on the blockchain done with Ethereum. So I thought that was really cool. Then Leanne Kamp is one of the grand ladies in production, putting thousands and thousands and thousands of diamonds on the blockchain. And I think that is, she's really explaining, she's now been in production for a couple of years, and she's building a big ecosystem and everybody's uniting around her. She's from Australia and she will be there at the blockchain conference. Fantastic presentation. So in a couple of other videos, I've talked about all the other speakers, but we're ending in the blockchain for good. And there's a whole bunch of people from the World Bank, birth certificates on the blockchain for refugees. We're talking about how to reform a big, huge industry with Pradeep, the healthcare industry, and how to make it more transparent. And Vinny Kopta is giving a fantastic presentation at the end to put everything in a big picture. And I'll have an interview with him next week. But also, we have Wakar Zaka. He's from Pakistan, and he has more than a million fans on Facebook. Everywhere he goes, he immediately has hundreds of thousands of views. And he is a TV star, and he does all kinds of crazy things there. But the interesting thing is, he's going into countries like Syria, takes refugees and teaches them about the blockchain, and teaches them how, with the blockchain knowledge, they can build their own income. You know, he's giving them mining equipment, and he's teaching them how to work with that. He makes them independent. So he's a really interesting guy. He will talk about it. He has his own foundation. He's an interesting guy. I interviewed him when he was in the Netherlands last time. He just went to New York, to Consensus. We're going to talk about that, where are the trends there. But it's about how can you use the blockchain for good, but also how incredibly popular it is in countries like Pakistan, like India, you know, like Japan. I mean, this whole blockchain is it's a completely Asian, the Asians are very enthusiastic about it. In the same week as our conferences, there is also Money 2020, where 4,500 people are coming from all over the world, and we have fantastic keynotes, and it's all about fintech innovation. So that's going to be huge, and we have a lot of people there, and I also will talk about the different things. I will go to the blockchain track, and I will present a couple of cases there, and we have a couple of sessions there. And one of the interesting sessions is where I'm going to talk with Mark van der Gijs about how the crypto world is developing, especially how the finance industry is getting into it and the connections, and how that is probably going to be interesting for the whole crypto economy. Pradeep Goel is how we change existing business, and Jeremy Miller is from Consensus, you know, big, huge company which builds solutions. And Andy Zondervan, who is in the music industry. And we're going to have a session where we answer all the questions about technology, how to make it scalable, how to use it for real-life production. Oh, yeah, I also talked about in the Financial Telegraaf, we had a session about where we talked about what the members of parliament thought about it, how the Bitcoin is developing. So that's a Dutch thing, which is not going to be interesting for the English-speaking, but that's a nice session. And if you want to be interested, if you want to come, there's going to be a live stream, so you can see everything. But also, if you want to come, I have a nice thing. It's $4.95, but if you use Vincent as promo code, then you get 30% discount. So that's maybe interesting. So then it's going down to that price. So I hope you will be there. We have about 60 tickets available out of the 400 which are there. So we're getting low. So if you want to come, then come, and otherwise take a look at the live stream. All right, see you there, and have a wonderful weekend, and look at all the articles and videos we've published, because it's really accelerating. It's really everywhere. Every part of the industry is being influenced, and June the 7th will be a wonderful day to celebrate that incredible change from POC, from proof of concept to production. I also went to the Next Web. And the Next Web, I went there virtually because I was sick in bed. I mean, I had an incredible nausiness problem, but I was stuck to the screen. And the Next Web is also interesting. 15,000 people were looking at everything from artificial intelligence to blockchain to all the startups. And then it was a beautiful day to look at. Interesting. They had a couple of little things. So blockchain, there was a whole big, huge track on blockchain. And a nice demo there. where they showed that with a phone, making photos, for example, of a diamond or other things, they could verify if something was for real. There's a lot of startups working on that. There's already huge companies working on that, but IBM turned AI and blockchain into a phone hunter anti-counterfeit detector. So I thought that was one thing which I thought was nice. And the second thing which was nice was that by buying a ticket, they would invest into the next web would invest in a hard fork in their ICO, eToro. And then any profit they make until July the 36th, 50% is paid back to the audience. So you could potentially make your ticket back. So I thought that was a very creative way to work on there. My biggest hero, one of my oldest biggest hero in new thinking, is Kevin Kelly. He was the ex-Wired editor-in-chief. And he's always great in new thinking. Out of Control was all about the swarm mentality, the rules for the new economy, what technology wants, and he makes great book, and he made now the inevitable, what's really going to happen. And he had a great presentation about the mesh, how that is working. I was able to tape it from my phone. The quality is not the greatest, but you can really see him at the next web. He made a fantastic presentation. And it's all about what happens when augmented reality and virtual reality becomes commonplace, becomes everywhere, that everything is connected. The Internet of Things is coming, of course, we know that. Virtual reality, augmented reality, but then he's describing that new world and who's going to be the big players and how much power do they have. And data is going to be even more important. So I thought that was, for me, the highlight of the next web on Thursday. So I invite you all to look at it. Then we have a little thing about, of course, Tesla was in the news again a couple of times. One thing was interesting. A consumer reporter, who is normally very enthusiastic about Tesla, had a report about that the Model 3 was nice, but there were some problems with the screen, and especially it took too long to brake. So that's why they said that the overall score was low. And Tesla immediately braking test had a problem. And what they immediately reacted to say, oh yeah, well, we designed it to have an extremely short braking rate, that's what Elon Musk said, and we'll just issue a software update to make sure that we are into the spec. And then immediately Consumer Reports said, okay, we will retest it when it gets there. So that's really interesting. Elon Musk also had a huge amount of fights in Twitter about with journalists who he accused of not being fair. And then, of course, they said, are you like Trump with fake news? And he says, yeah, well, there are a lot of mistakes which the journalists make. So it was a beautiful big fight. Trump and Elon Musk accused of the same thing. So that was interesting. And the last thing I want to say, that in Holland, that the amount of sales of electric car went up a factor of 3. They are now sold 10 times more, 15 times more than LPG, natural gas cars. So I thought that was really cool. It's now 22 or 23% of the diesel cars. So that's also, you know, and it's growing so fast that it doesn't take much long. I don't think it will take 2 years before more electric cars are sold on diesel. And then, of course, the gasoline cars are next. And Bayonair had a nice interview about that, and there's all kinds of stuff all over the news around that. So that was really cool. And also, I thought Danielle Hogendijk I met, and she is an electric driving coach. And I thought I made a nice interview with that. And for 69 euros, if you're ever interested, for 69 euros, she gives a 1 hour drive in an electric car, in a Hyundai or a Nissan Leaf. Tells you all the things you need to know about the electric car, and she's an independent electric coach, and she can also help you to select a car. And for 69 euro, she's coming to you, picks you up, gives you a drive. I thought that was also really nice. But it's a Dutch interview. Okay, I do everything in English now. Thank you very much. This was the news of the week. I'll see you next week again. In 2 weeks, there is the Blockchain Innovation Conference. So come virtually or in reality, and come and enjoy the incredible rate of progress we're going to see, and we're going to celebrate that day. It's going to be huge, interesting, lots of speakers. I want you there.